The last thing that I want to quickly discuss are some functions that usually exist in query languages like SQL, such as group bys and aggregate functions. So let's say that I wanted to create some transformed version of my data. For example, what are the total number of enrollments per district? I could write something like this. Select district, sum Aadhaar generated, from Aadhaar data, group by district. Let's talk about this a little bit more. What's happening exactly? Sum is what we call an aggregate function. An aggregate function takes some set of values, usually numbers, and performs a mathematical operation on them. We've used sum, but other aggregate functions include count, min, mean, max. You get the idea. Operations that one could perform on a collection of numbers. But wait, every single row is only one number. So how do we get to collections of numbers? What we basically say here is take each distinct district. And then for all of the different values of Aadhaar generated corresponding to a row for that district, sum them up. So we start with our Aadhaar data table, take each district, and sum up the count of Aadhaar generated. Now, in order for our results to make sense, we're only going to want one row in our output for each district. So we throw in this group by clause on the end, which essentially says, let's only have one row per district in our results. There can be numerous clauses in a group by. So we could also say this, select district, subdistrict, sum Aadhaar generated from Aadhaar data, group by district, subdistrict. Note that whatever columns we select that we don't aggregate, we need to group by, in this case, district and subdistrict. We could also put a where clause here. So in order to sum up Aadhaar generated for people over 60 in each district, I can just add a where clause in after the table name, as we discussed earlier. If we were to run this query, giving us select district, subdistrict, sum Aadhaar generated from Aadhaar data, where age greater than 60, group by district, subdistrict. If we were to run this query, we would have a row for every combination of district and subdistrict. And we would also have for each row a count of how many Aadhaar were generated for people over the age of 60.